We have people that love to sing, and the pastor's moving toward shoring up a musical program. And it's going to happen. It really is. And then when that happens, all of you that can sing have to say, I'm going to pay the price to sing in that thing. Whatever they do. Are you willing to do that? Are you ready to do that?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Okay. That's great. That was a good positive response. And, you know, Lindsay and Jackie back there, I can't see that far back. Yeah, that is Lindsay.
Yes.
In this right eye, I have a problem, and so if my sight is getting worse and worse. But it may be better I'll come before the congregation someday and I won't have to look at anybody. That. Amen. But Jackie and Lindsay started this recovery program. And I want to tell you that that's a wonderful ministry. And I realize that some thought, well, what is going on with that bunch and all this kind of stuff, you know? But it's just a little matter of training and that kind of thing. I see the Discovery Ministry furnishing to this church many new prospects. Some of them are here today. Some are back there. Some are here. They're sitting out here. They come Wednesday night. I teach some on Monday night. Davis teaches some on Friday night. I teach some on Wednesday night. And so we have a lot of things going on with the Discovery Ministry. And then Lindsay leads the group on those nights. We have a children's ministry. See, we were talking about this today, about our problem. And our problem is that when you get down to about 50, everything's cut off in this church. You know what I mean? There isn't anybody else. We're all this side. And there's nothing wrong with being on that side. I happen to be on that side. And I don't, if you think I resent it, I don't. Flabbergasted sometimes, but. We've got a lot of things going on in this church. And this is only the beginning. I've talked to the pastor, and I'm not going to break any confidences, if you won't tell. I'm okay. I talked to the pastor about some things, and Davis and I are going to talk to him about some more things. And we're going to brainstorm this thing. Along with some of you, he's going to be in the lead. We're going to be helping him as pastor, holding his hands up, and helping him stay encouraged, motivated. We envision some other things in this church and community that we think are going to help. Now, we're moving slowly, folks. We really are. It's going to take us a little time to get there. Can you hang with us?
Yes.
Can you really do that?
Yes.
Okay. Now, you might bring your neighbor next Sunday, okay? Can you do that?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Thank you. All right. What time is it? Is it time to go?
Okay, yes.
My wife just told me. I have no idea why I wore a tie this morning. I mean, nothing was planned. And I came in to dress. And all my ties were lying on the bed. And I thought, that's strange. Do we have a tie thief in this house somewhere? That's what it is. It's kind of new. And when Abigail wants to communicate with me, she does that. In this case, it was ties, so she laid my ties on the bed. And I had an instant decision to make. Shall I rebel? Like any self-respecting man would do? Shall I put one of them on? Which is what I did, and which is what you would do, men. If you were married, I know. Incidentally, happy Valentine's Day. Okay, I've got 2 minutes, so let me try to finish up something here. What are we to do for ourselves this day? Well, he tells us in these verses, first of all, rise. Rise. Man was flat on his back, wallowing in self-pity. Nobody's helped him for 38 years and all that kind of stuff, you know. And so Jesus simply said, get up, rise. And so self-pity invites you to stand still and ask, why me? That's what this guy did. Why me? Lord, why me? 38 years I've been lying here and I've been trying to get there and all this kind of stuff. And Jesus simply said, you want to be well? Get up. Now that's pretty straightforward, isn't it?
Amen.
Second thing he asked was, take up your bed. Do what the Lord gives you the power to do. Father was talking to his son and said, can you do anything that you set your mind to do? Toothpaste back in the tube again. Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. And let me tell you about the question